Hey guys, today we're going to be talking about stubby antennas. I never thought we'd be talking about this, but a lot of people have been asking me where I have gotten this. Now, I actually purchased this particular antenna with the car, but I found a suitable replacement for you guys. So quickly looking at some online documentation, antenna placement and grounding, nothing much you can do about antenna placement, but again, backing up that how important it is to ground your system will help improve your antenna, help improve your radio reception. Now, here is the antenna that I'm speaking of. This one looks almost identical to the one that I have in my car, except this one doesn't have the little cut lines in it. I don't think any of you are going to really care about that. I think all people care about is the profile of the antenna and the height. So it's only $28.88 at Zen One Motorsports. So I've been looking everywhere actually for something like this. A lot of people have asked me about it. I've tried searching on eBay, Amazon, nothing universal. And luckily I just stumbled upon this here. So if you guys want to pick up something like my antenna, this is the one to go for. Now I can see why people don't like the factory antenna. It's very tall and it makes it pretty much look like a toy RC car. There is another version I've seen that's a little bit shorter, but it's really floppy. And when you get up close, when you're like, you know, 5 feet away, 3 feet away from the vehicle, it looks cheap. And I think that's why a lot of people are asking about this one, because this one has like a billet kind of construction to it. So if you're going to take off your antenna, it's just threaded on, whether aftermarket or factory, and just twist it off. Now, if you're noticing a little bit of corrosion there, I would just spray just a little bit of some sort of penetrating lube. So I'm using Seafoam Deep Creep. Now, what I do is I'll take the original antenna, screw it on, and screw it out a bunch of times. Hopefully then, you know, this is going to clean the threads, because we still want to have good radio reception when we're done. Now, once this is done, I'll go ahead, blow that out with compressed air, and then wipe it clean. Taking a look at our aftermarket antenna, you see that there's a stud adapter, and it looks like it's been glued inside. So what we're going to do is we're going to put a little bit of thread lock, just a little bit. I don't really check my antenna for how tight it is, so I don't want it coming off while driving. Also, you know, if it would be thiefer to come around, I don't want them just to walk up in my car and easily take this off. I want them to put some effort into it, so hopefully they just give up and move on. Okay, here you have your thread lock on there. You're just gonna go ahead and twist it on. Now the alternative that I found at Z1 is from Parent, and the cool thing about it from what I can see in the diagram is its base is flared out a little bit more, so it matches up with the base of the antenna mount on the fender. Now what a big question is, a lot of people ask, are you going to lose reception? Now technically yes, we are degrading the signal strength or the ability to capture signal strength because we have a shorter antenna, but there's a couple things that we can do. So if you refer to my video where we installed the head unit into a 350Z, there's a couple things we did. We ran a new ground wire and then we hit the subframe inside the dash to make sure it has a good ground. Also, we make sure we turn on the amp turn on wire. So these cars have an amplified antenna in the back and that's how they pick up radio reception. A lot of the times you'll notice that AM reception or FM reception is degraded when you have the vehicle running. So you're getting some sort of interference coming off of the ignition system. But there are a couple times where I've seen, it's happening more recently, people will have some sort of device plugged into their cigarette lighter, and that's causing interference. Okay, let's go ahead and test this. Now keep in mind, my example is anecdotal, and there's a couple things going on here. If you were to just fire up a head unit on the bench, or plug in some sort of antenna adapter, that wire will actually act like an antenna. Try it. If you're ever working with car audio equipment, we've done that where we'll plug an antenna adapter in that's like 12 inches long, up to 24 inches long, and we'll get your reception. We'll do that for customers where if they don't want to pay for an amplify antenna because it's a classic car, ruins the look, and they just need something if they're just parked, it does work. Also, our vehicle is really well grounded, so that helps it out quite a bit as well. And we have a premium style head unit. So what we're going to do is we're going to turn the volume a little bit. I can only go on each channel for a very short period of time due to copyright. Now, note here, I have it on seek, not manual. if I have it on manual, what will happen is it will just literally go up one unit at a time. So to be fair, in order to see if the radio is getting reception properly, it's just automatically going to scan through the band, and if the number stops, it has received the channel. So we'll turn up the volume a bit.
That they did take there in that first round.
Period of time. I think that the time
as well, Queensboro and
when it comes to
you're safe in long-term queue.
Remember, this is on AM. This is the weaker band.
Stay home.
So we confirm AM works. So let's go ahead and check out our FM. You see the RDS for the radio data system, it works. So we're seeing the station on FM. We're also seeing the song and the artist.
The best thing you can do is stay home.
So as you can see, I can just keep going, and I'm getting all of the stations. Now, granted, this will change depending on the area that I'm in. So if I'm driving on a highway on a rural road, I'm not going to get any radio reception at all. You'd have to resort to satellite radio or your phone or whatever you have saved on the head unit. But as far as being in a suburban area, this works just fine. In another video, we did an elaborate grounding system for our 350Z. So we actually ran ground from the battery through the factory boot, and we did a perimeter around the vehicle. So the objective was is to remove any ground loops by connecting everything everywhere we could. So that way, if there's a difference in sheet metal, if there's a poor weld somewhere, we're going to bypass that and we're going to rely on the copper. And when it comes to electronic performance and including radio reception, ground of the vehicle is extremely important. I was actually surprised because I've had so many people complain about AM reception in the shop, and I just happened to be driving my car in a different city, and I just wanted to listen to the traffic report to see what was going on, and I just couldn't believe how crystal clear it was, and I really attribute that to how well this car has been grounded. So if you look over here, from factory they do ground things. A lot of people will say, like, you know, we would ground the engine and we would talk about how things would work better, and a lot of people say, well, all those electronics like sensors and everything are getting ground from the PCM. That's where their reference to ground is. That's true. However, the PCMs are rarely ever grounded directly to the battery. And you can see here, every vehicle is different. This one has a few ground wires on the engine itself. So by connecting everything everywhere we can, we reduce the chance of having ground loops. We're making sure that that resistance is as low as possible so all the electronic devices can work as best as they can. Well, there you guys go. I do believe stubby antennas do work, but there's a couple things that you have to do. Upgrading the grounds under the hood never hurts. You know, everything's going to work better under there, and you're going to flow a lot better amperage through your charging system. Also, upgrading the ground behind the head unit is going to help it out a ton.